Hello students, today we are discussing about chapter 1, that is real number. It is represented by capital letter R. Now what are real numbers? Real numbers are the collection of rational and irrational numbers. It means कि जब हम रैशनल और इरेशनल नंबर्स को मिला देते हैं तो वो सारे नंबर्स जो आते हैं उनको हम रियल नंबर्स कहते हैं. सो रियल नंबर्स डेट इज क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू पार्ट्स, वन इज रैशनल नंबर एंड सेकंड वन इज इरेशनल नंबर. रैशनल नंबर रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय कैपिटल लेटर क्यू एंड इरेशनल नंबर रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय कैपिटल आर माइनस कैपिटल लेटर क्यू. Now, definition of the rational number is rational number which can be written in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equals to 0. It means rational numbers की तीन conditions होती हैं. Firstly, के हम numbers को P by Q के रूप में लिख सकते हैं, that is numerator by denominator, and Q are integers. P और Q क्या होने चाहिए? Integers होने चाहिए. And the last condition is that is Q, that is denominator. Denominator not equals to 0. Now we are discussing the irrational number. Irrational number are just reverse of rational, that which cannot be written in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equals to 0. It means वो number जिनको हम ना तो P by Q के रूप में लिख सकते हैं, ना ही P Q integers होने चाहिए, and denominator not equals to 0. Just its reverse. Now we are classifying the decimal numbers. Decimal numbers are classified into two parts. That first is terminating and another one is non-terminating. Terminating, in which division gets completed. Suppose that 5 divided by 2. The decimal is 2.5. Now in this fraction division gets completed. So this is known as terminating. जब division हमारी complete खत्म हो जाए, remainder zero आ जाए, तो हम उन decimals को बोलते हैं terminating. Now non-terminating. Non-terminating when division does not get completed. Non-terminating classified into two parts. That is non-terminating and recurring. And non-terminating and non-recurring. Recurring here word also resemble to the repeating. Non-terminating. For example, 10 divided by 3, the decimal expansion is 3.333 and goes to infinity. It means after decimal 3 repeated many times. So we can write here 3.3 bar. Bar ka matlab hota hai ke jo ye 3 hai after decimal, it repeated many times. Now non-terminating and non-recurring. Ab non-terminating, ek to division bhi complete nahi hui hai and non-recurring aur repeat bhi nahi hue hain. Such decimal expansion are 2.13456 72 and goes to infinity. In this decimal expansion the division does not get completed and after decimal number also not getting repeating. Now we are discussing theorem 1.1, that is Euclid's division lemma. Euclid division lemma, that is given positive integer a and b, there exist unique whole number q and r such that a इज इक्वल्स टू बी क्यू प्लस आर. अब जैसे कि हमने प्राइमरी क्लासेस में पढ़ा था डेट डिविडेंड इज इक्वल्स टू डिवाइजर इन टू कोशेंट प्लस रिमाइंडर. हेयर डिविडेंड बिकम्स ए, बी बिकम्स डिवाइजर, कोशेंट बिकम्स क्यू एंड रिमाइंडर बिकम्स आर. नाउ दिस फॉर्मूला represent in the general form, that is a is equals to bq plus r. This general form is known as Euclid's division lemma. This Euclid's division lemma also satisfied the condition that remainder is greater than 0 or equals to 0 but less than b. Now b represent the divisor and the other name of b is HCF. Now we are finding HCF by two methods. First is here finding HCF by two ways, by Euclid's division lemma and by prime factorization method. Firstly, we are finding HCF by Euclid's division lemma. Suppose that taking two numbers, that is 25 and 40, 40 greater than 25, by long division we can divide here 25 as a divisor and 40 as a dividend. 25 into 25, remainder comes 15. Now divisor gets becomes dividend. Now 15 one ja 15, remainder 10. Now 15 comes as a dividend. Now 10 one ja 10, remainder 5, And now this divisor becomes dividend. 5 to the 10 remainder comes here 0. Now finding HCF by using Euclid's division lemma, that is A is equals to BQ plus R. Here A, that is 40, is equals to B. B, it means divisor. Divisor is your 25. And 25 into quotient, that is 1, plus remainder is 15. Now repeated these steps. Now repetition of these steps is known as division algorithm, that is Euclid's division algorithm. Now 25, that divisor becomes the dividend, and remainder becomes the divisor. Like here 15 into 1 plus 10 is equals to 25. Here 25 comes here, 15 comes here, 15 vanja 15 plus 10, that is remainder 25. Now this 15 comes here and this remainder becomes a divisor. Again repeated this step up to when the remainder does not comes 0. Here in the last step, remainder becomes 0. Now B is your 5, the other name of B is your HCF. Therefore HCF of 25 and 40 is 5. Now using the second method, by prime factorization method, taking the same number, that is 25 and 40, take the prime factors of 25 by taking LCMs and 40 by LCMs. Now represent 25 as their prime factors and represent 40 as their prime factors. The common multiple of both the numbers is 5. Therefore, HCF, that is highest common factor of 25 and 40, is 5. Now we are finding LCM. Taking again 25 and 40, we are finding LCM by prime factorization method. That is 5, prime factors of 25 are 5 and 5. And prime factors of 40s are this. Now this 5 is the common factor, so common factor takes one time and the remaining prime factors taking multiple. Multiply this all, 25 into 5 into 2 into 2 into 2, the product is 200. Now LCM of 25 and 40 is 200. Now we are studying one relationship, that is formula also we can say that HCF into LCM is equals to product of two number. HCF we are finding of 25 and 40. Let 25 be the first number and 40 be the second number. Now LCM of 25 and 40 we are finding, that is 200, and HCF of 25 and 400 is 5. Now verification of this relationship or formula, that is LCM into HCF is equals to product of two numbers. LCM, that is 200, HCF, that is 5, and product of two number, and two numbers are, that is 25 and 40. Now 200 into 5, that is 1000, 25 into 40, that is 1000. It means left hand side is equals to right hand side, hence verified. So we can say that LCM and HCF is equals to product of two numbers. Thank you.